I'm Maggie, and most people call me Grandma. I love to be called Grandmother. I don't consider myself as being a hoarder, but I don't know. It's hard to walk through my house the way it is now and just see a lot of stuff that I bought that I shouldn't have bought. I'm ashamed of my house the way it is.
I'm Zenith, and Maggie is my grandmother. The condition of the house at this time is so full you can't even open up the front door. There's piles and piles of clothes everywhere. It's chaos.
I'm Peaches, and Maggie is my mom. She would not consider herself a hoarder. She considers herself a smart buyer.
Yes, I'm very good at shopping. I'd like to go in the store and look at clothes and things.
She has nice things, but she has too much of it.
It devastated me, but I never cried. Just never cried.
I don't think she grieved properly. So she started shopping, and that was her therapy.
It was like, this is the only way I can solve my problem. I just got to the place that I just had to buy, and I just end up going bananas. Going from one aisle down to another aisle, down to another aisle. I would come in here and I'd take it and throw it across the floor.
I'm Cece, and Maggie is my grandmother, but I think of her as my mom. I refer to the house as the monster house. It started off, as I remember, just normal clutter, but then over the years, it just built up, like we couldn't even sleep on our bed. When it came to showering and cleanliness, couldn't use a sink, and we'd have to use our portable stoves to heat up the water, and we'd have to take it outside and shower. It was just very frustrating because no one knew about it. She made me promise that I would never tell anyone or my family about it, that what goes on in our house stays in our house.
I went to her house one day, and I saw Cece walking over top of stuff, and I'm saying, how are you living in this house? I got so upset. I didn't know things had gotten this bad. I took Cece that day and told her she had to stay with me. The house has been totally closed up for the last 4 years. What we did not know was that my mother still had a set of keys. So I found out she's been shopping and been taking stuff to the house.
She would be like, I'm going home to clean the house, when in reality, she's going home to store stuff.
I want to come back in my house, and I want to get my house back.
I'm Dante, and Maggie is my great-great-grandma. I don't want to see my grandma get hurt. She's climbing through that stuff, and then something falls on her, and she can't get out.
I know for a fact that if my grandma couldn't return to her house, something bad would happen.
I just feel sad.
All right, Grandma Maggie. There's a lot of stuff in your house, as you know.
Yeah.
My name's Matt Paxton. I'm an extreme cleaning specialist. And the really way for me to make a dent in there is to bring everything from your living room to out here on the tarps. Normally, I like to just take my time, get to know the hoarder, but not with this hoard. This house is full. I need literally every second to say, hey, Maggie, nice to meet you. I'm Matt. I gotta start pulling stuff out. Are you going to allow me to try to help you and give to you in the next couple days?
Yes.
Okay, let me get my guys, okay? My hunch is that Grandma Maggie's not going to let us get rid of much. So I just got to start pulling stuff out and see how she reacts.
This is my Kleenex. Those are my slippers. This right here is brand new. This is my duster that I get up underneath of my thing. Wait a minute. Let me tell you what. This is medical tape.
Come on, that's dirty. Medical tape. It's dirty.
I'm Dr. Robin Zazio. I specialize in helping people struggling with hoarding disorder. We're sorting outside, and things are not going well at all.
Wait a minute.
Grandma, you can't spend this much time on these items. You got to look at it and make a decision.
That's what I'm looking to see, what size they are. I don't know what size they are.
Grandma is picking up every single item. This is not going to allow us to achieve our goal.
Let the organizers do all that. Don't take time doing that, Grandma.
Maggie just likes to see what she's got. She's not interested in getting rid of anything. I'm sitting on the tarp with Dr. Zazio, and in 5 minutes in, we're looking at each other like we're in trouble. All right, time out.
Time out.
What are you thinking for clothes and whatnot? What is your thoughts on that? Talking to you,
Grandma.
Are you listening to me? You know when you get somebody that they hit a certain age and they're just like, screw it, I'm gonna do whatever I wanna do? Well, Maggie hit that about 3 years ago. This is gonna be a long week, man.
Grandma.
What?
I need you to stop trying to pick up everything that's on the ground.
I'm picking up my money.
That wasn't money.
It was a penny.
It's day two. I don't have that much time left. I'm just looking at this house, and I don't see how we're gonna get it done.
Okay, Grandma, so we need to make some decisions, because all this stuff gotta go.
All of it don't have to go. Don't tell me I have to let all of it go, because I don't have to let all of it go.
One of my biggest challenges is Grandma. She's copping an attitude.
Just keep quiet, please. Don't need to keep bringing it up. I don't want to hear it no more.
I don't know how to clean this house without making her upset. It's not working. So I'm just gonna shove the family in the back room and let them work for an hour and see what happens.
This is trash.
Wait a minute. That's not no trash.
Hand me that for a minute, please.
That right there is not dirty.
Okay, well, this is going in the trash.
How you know that that's going in the trash? That right there is brand new, Dante. See you. Don't get over that side. I just bought that white blouse last week.
I can't be in here.
All this is going in the trash.
What's up? What's going on?
I don't know. Everything's just frustrating me because my grandma, too, she's just... I want to save this, I want to save that. And I just want to get the house clean so I can come back home.
Cece didn't have a good childhood in this home. She wants to get the house cleaned out so that she can start to create new memories.
Grandma, baby.
You don't have to cry, Cece. Please stop crying. Because you have no blood pressure.
It breaks my heart to see her upset at any time. That's my child.
This conversation has turned into an opportunity for Grandma to let things go and do whatever it takes to get the house in order. Grandma, listen to me. I want you to make her a promise right now that tomorrow when we leave, that house will be clean.
Clean, but I promise you, that's
okay,
what I'm
you hear that?
Doing now. I promise you.
Grandma just did it. She said Cece's more important than the stuff. Throw it away. And now I got a free pass. Yesterday, I made Cece and Grandma a promise that we're gonna finish this house. And today's the day. Either I'm gonna do it, or I'm not. It's not gonna be a fun day. We run out of time. We work to the very last minute. In fact, we're in overtime, to be honest. We're gonna have mixed emotions when we walk in there. You know, usually a walkthrough is rainbows and puppies, and we're looking at the shiny floor, and everything's awesome. That's not it today. You ready, Grandma?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
We're walking through the house, and unfortunately, it's not the celebratory moment that we would like to have, but most of the house is cleaned out.
This is really nice.
It may not look incredible, but we've given this entire family a chance to start new.
Grandma, you did great.
You know, you fought us some of the way, but you did let us throw away over 60,000 pounds of trash out of here. You're proud of Grandma Ranger. This is a win. It may not look like it, but this is one of the bigger wins I've ever seen.
What are your thoughts, Cece?
This is great. Like, I'm on the floor, and I can actually dance, and I can bring my best friend over here. We could turn up.
So awesome. I feel like it's the start of something new. I'll be able to make new memories. I'll be able to finally just get to chill in my house.
I can say this for Cece, welcome home.
That just made me want to cry.
Somebody give that girl a hug.
Love ya.
I'm happy because I'm going to be back at home. And we're going to live happy ever after.
Hi, thanks for being a fan of Hoarders. And subscribe to A&E for more videos and click the links around me to watch more.